we turn to the underreported story of what is happening to China's Muslim minority known as Uyghurs. This weekend, however, the news was full of this story thanks to a famous soccer player. Arsenal star Mesut Ozil has criticized China's treatment of Uyghurs and also the silence of the Muslim world. He is Turkish and Muslim himself. In response, China immediately pulled coverage of an Arsenal game from state television and later invited Ozil to Xinjiang, where most Uyghurs live, to see for himself. In our latest special report on the Uyghurs, correspondent Matt Rivers shows us the crackdown by way of Uyghur cemeteries that are being leveled and built over.
Right there, okay.
And this is Gary Yatier.
When Aziz Issa Elkun's father died, it was too dangerous for him to go to the funeral in China. Aziz is an ethnic Uyghur who lives in exile in North London, but he grew up in a Western Chinese region called Xinjiang, an area activists say is the center of an unparalleled human rights crisis in the world today.
This is not a normal state, normal country can do like it is. This is a pure evilness.
Xinjiang is where the United Nations says the Chinese government has detained hundreds of thousands of Muslim ethnic minorities, including Uyghurs, over the past several years. Critics say China is doing that to try and eliminate Islam within its borders. Some detainees are seen here in leaked video, blindfolded and shackled as they're transferred between places. Former detainees have told CNN they're kept in a massive network of detention camps where inside allegations of torture abound. China's government denies that and says they're just offering vocational training designed to fight extremism. But earlier this year, we tried to see those camps for ourselves and were met with police.
Ma'am, can you tell me what that is? Is this something that you don't want us to see?
Why you are here? You tell me, why you are here? Why you are here?
We're here to film what we believe is a camp.
My father's tomb just used to be here.
In London, Aziz tells us his father was buried in this tomb near his family home in central Xinjiang. In the past, he visited him the only way he could, by using Google Earth to see the tomb from above. But in June, the satellite image changed. Before, rows of tombs, now a largely empty flattened field.
What happened to your father's remains?
I don't know. I have no idea.
In a months-long investigation, working with sources in the Uyghur community and analyzing hundreds of satellite images, CNN has found more than 100 cemeteries that have been destroyed, most in just the last 2 years. Like this one in the town of Aksu, a cemetery first demolished, then redeveloped with a man-made pond. Or this one in Shayar, distinctive white tombs leveled and simply built over. The AFP first reported on this destruction and visited some sites. At three different places, they said they found human bones. CNN has also found multiple government notices online, in one case giving families just 15 days to move remains. We showed these images to Ryan Thumb, an anthropologist who studies Islam in China and uses satellite imagery to study this region.
There's no doubt in your mind what that is.
Right. No, this is absolutely clear what this is. You can see the destruction encroaching. And now if you look at Google Earth today, you'll see that this sort of flat surface that now covers everything. And that is a phenomenon stretching right across the region of Xinjiang.
In response, the Chinese government did not deny the cemetery destruction. They said in part, quote, governments in Xinjiang fully respect and guarantee the freedom of all ethnic groups to choose cemeteries and funeral and burial methods. In public documents, official reasons for the destruction include wanting to build, quote, civilized cemeteries to promote progress. Uyghur cemeteries are central to village life, a place to meet and connect one generation to the last.
It's akin to, for an American, seeing Arlington Cemetery raised and the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier dug up and paved over. It's a great act of desecration and a kind of open insult to Uyghur culture.
We are stronger together.
Aziz believes it's a desecration that will have a backlash.
We cannot live anymore with them together because they're committing genocide against the Uyghur people.
In Xinjiang, it seems even the dead can't rest. Matt Rivers, CNN, London.